Daniel Buren is perhaps France's most famous living contemporary artist. He began as a painter, but in 1965 hit upon an idea to try and claim what he called the degree zero of painting, which was a conceptual notion perhaps inspired by Roland Barthes, the French critic and philosopher whose first book was entitled Writing Degree Zero. And the idea was to begin from a minimal point at which painting could expand and go beyond the canvas. So after painting various circular and striped motifs in the early 1960s and 1965, he found a striped material at a flea market in Paris and decided to use this material with an 8.7 centimeter stripe as this kind of degree zero from which to work from. So this motif of the stripe became his trademark, if you will, and has become the point from which all of Buren's work has sprung. From the canvas, his work went onto the street, onto awnings, onto the walls, onto fly posters, and onto street furniture, taking painting out of the galleries and off the canvas, essentially onto the street, painting becoming sculpture, and painting becoming public art. Of the two new pieces Buren has made for BALTIC, the first piece on the façade, which is called 20 Diamonds for the Façade, consists of coloured light cells going all the way up the front of BALTIC and involves what Buren has been using for the last decade or so, these kind of coloured light filters or light cells that change the colour of the landscape outside, kind of washing the viewer with a different colour depending on conditions of the day and the light outside. The installation on level 4, Catch as Catch Can, involves these puddles of light that appear on the floor, bathing on visitors' clothes and on the architecture of the building. Indeed, the audience are acted and acted upon by the work, activating the work as they travel around. The mirrors form a dual function, not only reflecting and refracting the viewer and also the architecture around, but they create a situation that's almost theatrical or playful in which the viewer is involved in a complex ballet or dance, much as Buren has worked on designing stage sets for plays or for ballets. So the movement of people within the installations is part of the work, but also the differing views that you get of yourself and others, creating something very close to public art in a gallery space. The notion that Buren's work differs with each exhibition is as true here as anywhere else, although we have the familiar motifs, the stripes and the zigzags and the cubes and colours. But indeed, what Buren manages to do seemingly in each new city or new space that he inhabits is to capture the spirit of the place, somehow capture the quality of light that's appropriate for the setting, and also create something new each time. So although you might be familiar with his work or with the coloured panes of glass, the idea is that the experience should be new each time for each individual viewer.